Well, everything checks out fine. I'm certifying you fit for duty.
Finally. Last time I spoke with Kira, she wanted to know when I'd be rejoining her.
There is something you need to know. When I first discovered that you had become infected with the morphogenic virus, I assumed you'd contracted it from the Founders.
But didn't I?
No. The fact is, it was you who transmitted the disease to them.
How did I get it?
You were deliberately infected.
By whom?
Section 31. They used you as a carrier, hoping you would pass on the disease to the Founders.
The Federation set out to destroy my people.
Section 31 aren't part of the Federation. They're a rogue organization.
Don't split hairs with me, Doctor. They used me as an instrument to try to commit genocide. Now, we may be at war with the Founders, but that's no excuse.
And how long have you worked for Section 31?
I don't.
Just a temporary alliance, is it?
Something like that.
You don't see anything wrong with what happened, do you?
I don't like it. But I've spent the last year and a half of my life ordering young men and young women to die. I like that even less.
That's a glib answer. And a cheap way to avoid the fact that you've trampled on the very thing that those young men and women are out there dying to protect! Does that not mean anything to you?
Enter Arma. Einem Silent Legis.
In time of war, the law falls silent.
The Federation Council considered giving the Founders the cure. Then they decided against it.
Then they're abetting genocide.
I don't condone what Section 31 did, but the Founders started this war, not us. Giving them the cure would strengthen their hand. We can't do that. Not when there are still millions of men and women out there putting their lives on the line every day.
Well, I can see there's no use protesting. The decision's been made.
Odo, I wish I didn't have to say this, but I need to know you're not going to take matters into your own hands.
The Federation claims to abhor Section 31's tactics, but when they need the dirty work done, they look the other way. It's a tidy little arrangement, wouldn't you say?
But I showed it to you on the way in.
This has not been approved by the First.
Ah, yes, I can explain that.
How much time? You
must have the detonator only had a 3-minute delay. Bomb could go off any second now.
Come on, Garrick.
We have to do something.
I don't know why you're making such a fuss over this. I have a busy repair schedule, and I can't stand here all night and argue.
You will wait here till the First arrives.
And how long will that be?
You will wait! You! Jem'Hadar!
Who are you to treat a Cardassian citizen like that?
Jim! Damar! Hold him here! Surrender yourself or die!
I choose neither!
Back! Get back! Oh.
It's Damar! He's alive!
Citizens of Cardassia! Hear me! The Dominion told you that the rebellion has been crushed. What you have seen here today proves that that is yet another lie. Our fight for freedom continues, but it will take place here in the streets. I call on Cardassians everywhere to rise up. Rise up and join me. I need you to be my army. If we stand together, nothing can oppose us. Freedom is ours for the taking! Freedom!